these McDaniel family movies span 1948 to about 1953. In 1948, Mom and Dad and Eddie and baby Phil left San Francisco and headed to Thailand. There were people, of course, waving goodbye from the wharf. And in those days, it was the custom to attach streamers from the loved ones to the people on board the ship until those streamers broke and pulled away.
The voyage was made on one of the ships of the President lines, either the President Wilson or the President Cleveland. In those days, it was cheaper to go by boat than to fly. Part of the voyage involved a lifeboat drill. This was so that our ship wouldn't suffer the same fate as the Titanic, I suppose. Voyage took the young family from San Francisco to Shanghai and to Hong Kong.
Well, apparently there wasn't a whole lot to see other than to watch what the crew was up to. Partly things they needed to accomplish, and they did some of it while they were under sail. Here's the stopover that they made in Shanghai.
The Yangtze River flows through Shanghai and out into the Pacific Ocean, or perhaps we should say the South China Sea. The Yangtze River is very muddy, and there's a very clear demarcation between the Yangtze River water and the ocean water once you get past the Yangtze River.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. And I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands.
One of our favorite places to go on vacation, partly because it was cool and partly because it was a little bit remote and adventurous, using pressure lamps at night, was Kuntan. There were some mission cabins, and this was a place that many missionaries went for their vacation during the hottest month of the year, which was April. Orchids abounded in those days, growing on trees all through the forest. Water was brought down to the cabins via bamboo aqueducts. These were high maintenance, requiring frequent cleaning and frequent repair.
Now, being way down south, we usually went for vacations to the beach at Nong Khae. Incidentally, this beach rest area of Nong Khae was opened by my dad. It developed into a very useful rest area for the missionaries. But Nong Khae was a very small station, and normally the express train, which is what we always took, would not stop at Nong Khae, but by it thawing, by asking well ahead of time, one could get the train to make a special stop at Nong Khae. Usually they wouldn't do this unless there were a good many people either getting on or getting off. Well, we got off the train, usually in the middle of the morning, and started to make our trek from the railroad down to the beach. Very, very hot, going through a bamboo jungle, along paths deep in sand, usually behind an ox cart, which was taking our suitcases and our food parcels and other things that we needed for vacation down to the beach. And after a long walk in the hot sun through the jungle, we'd finally spy the ocean water off in the distance and begin to feel the cool breezes. And my goodness, that was certainly a treat.
Thank you. friend in me. You've got a friend in me. When the road looks rough ahead and you're miles and miles from your nice warm bed, you just remember what your old past said. Boy, you got a friend in me. Yeah, you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got trouble, and I got them too. There isn't anything I wouldn't do for you. We stick together, see it through, 'cause you've got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Now, some other folks might be a little bit smarter than I am, big and stronger too, maybe, but none of them will ever love you the way I do. It's me and you, boy, and as the years go by, a friendship will never die. You're gonna see it's our destiny. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me.
First I ride my bicycle very slowly, ba 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 ba, bicycle riding. Then I ride my bicycle a little bit faster, ba 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 ba, bicycle riding.
La mer qu'on voit danser le long des golfes clairs a des reflets d'argent. La mer, des reflets changeants sous la pluie. La mer au ciel d'été confond ses blancs moutons avec les anges si purs. La mer, bergère d'azur infinie. Voyez, près des étangs, ces grands roseaux mouillés. Voyez, ces oiseaux blancs et ces maisons rouillées. La mer.
For the love which from our birth Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Philip.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear Philip.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthdays!
A hospital ambulance was purchased during Dad's first term in Thailand. It was never intended for racing along paved roads with lights flashing and siren blaring. Rather, it was a Jeep with four-wheel drive for picking up or delivering patients who would have had difficulty getting to the hospital without it. On those dirt roads, the ambulance frequently got quite dirty and had to be washed periodically. Conveniently, there was a river that ran close to the hospital compound.
Like playing the fool, step out of line, break all the rules. Don't you let them tell you it's not for you. Don't go growing old before you're due. Stay young, keep your wheels in motion. You've got everything.
Trip back to the United States for our first furlough was, of course, an exciting adventure, not least because the ship we sailed on had a swimming pool. I remember my brother Ed telling me that it was easy to swim. You just jump in the water and swim. So I tried that one day and started to thrash around and did not stay afloat very well, so I grabbed on to the nearest person there who happened to be a young girl, and I kind of crawled up her so I could get some air. She did not appreciate it. After that, I was more careful to wear a life preserver. Early on in the voyage, there was a lifeboat drill.
I left in this footage of the water foaming up behind the ship because Dad was so very fond of taking footage of water, blue, blue water, and beautiful white foam.
On the ship, there was many means of entertainment, including shuffleboard and there were walks that could be taken on the promenade deck. The walk one lap around the ship seemed to me to be a long distance. The passengers were occasionally given access to the control room. Ed had a chance to steer the ship. Of course, there probably wasn't any real connection between the wheel and the direction of the ship.
Mom was always such a willing subject to point to things so that Dad's movies could be enhanced with some action and some interest.
Here is Diamond Head as the ship moves into the harbor at Hawaii.
How much of this footage I've already cut out, and there's still lots of it. Obviously, this was a movie maker's paradise for Dad.
One of these boats that took tourists up close to the falls was called the Maid of the Mist. Here are some tourists clad in raincoats going to take a trek close to the falls. Even the passengers on the Maid of the Mist wore rain gear. Carol is on the left, Mom to the right, and there is myself, Philip. Later in this cross-country trip, we went to Texas, where we visited my dad's brother, Uncle John. He took us fishing, and this was a new experience for us.
I think it would be safe to say Ed was not enjoying himself on this fishing expedition.
Dinosaur Park was lots of fun for Ed and I. We climbed all over these dinosaurs. And of interest is that the Triceratops here is, we think, exactly the same Triceratops that Mom was climbing on when Dad took pictures of her many years before.